From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. Gas prices are up 1 cent overnight to a statewide average of $3.77 a gallon for regular. News 8's Dave Guthrie explains what's behind the price increase.
Well, the rising costs of crude oil combined with the related concerns of tension in the Middle East are conspiring to cause rising gas prices continually here in the United States. Now, we're here on Commercial Street in Portland this morning. As you can see behind me, the Irving gas station here on Commercial Street is charging $3.66 per gallon of regular gas. Gas prices have gone up 1 cent in just the last day, and the statewide average now hovering around $3.77 a gallon for regular. In the past month, it has raised 24 cents. It was $3.53 just a month ago. Just wild, these numbers. Now, the good news here in southern Maine, a lot of the gas stations charging $3.75 or lower. But as you move north, the prices get worse. In Falmouth, $3.85. Up in Caribou and Presque Isle, nearly $4 per gallon of gas. And experts are warning that this trend could get worse before it gets better. In Portland, I'm Dave Guthrie for News 8.
Beginning today, crews of the Maine Department of Transportation will install camera equipment along Interstate 295. A spokesman for the DOT says the cameras will give drivers a chance to see traffic conditions during construction season, which of course begins later this year. Cameras will be installed on sign trusses in the median of the interstate. Installation of the cameras will wrap up on Wednesday. This morning, a Cumberland County Court jury selection begins for an Occupy Maine member accused of hitting a fellow protester in the head with a hammer back in November. Christopher Scheisler is charged with aggravated assault. Police say Scheisler became angry when Alan Porter, another Occupy Maine member, was drumming to awaken others in the encampment in Lincoln Park. Police say Scheisler hit Porter over the head with a hammer while another man choked him. Porter was treated at Maine Medical Center for a head injury.
Investigators from the state fire marshal's office will be in Norway later this morning to figure out what caused a fire that heavily damaged a home. Firefighters were called to 226 Dunn Road just before 7:30 last night. Firefighters say that it took about 3.5 hours to put out those flames. Firefighters from several towns were called to help, and two of them were sent to Stevens Memorial Hospital as a precaution. Fire Chief Dennis Yates tells News 8 that firefighters were able to save some of the animals inside the home. Well, this morning, the investigation continues into the disappearance of Florida firefighter Jerry Perdomo and father of two. State police say they suspect foul play. State police and detectives and Bangor police spent the weekend searching a house in the Waldo County town of Jackson. State police say that it could be the last place that Perdomo was seen.
Tonight, the Brunswick Town Council will meet regarding noise standards to a proposed train layover facility. New England Rail Authority wants to expand Downeaster train service from Portland to Brunswick. In order to do that, they say they need to build a 40,000-square-foot layover and maintenance site. People who live in the neighborhood surrounding the site are concerned about property values, noise, and safety from trains and the facility.
And thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We'll bring the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.